Jason, Tyson, and Barea out there are kind of obviously familiar faces. Wondering what their roles are, if they're fine, or if he's got to stop by when he has time.
For Tyson, he's part of our Mavs Legends program that Mark has created for past players. Tyson's now living here in the Dallas area. He wanted to kind of get his feet wet to see what coaching is all about. So we have him on board for our Mavs Legends program. Also, JJ is under that umbrella too. And so those are the two that have launched this program that Mark's created, and we're very excited to have that, you know, especially have those two guys who've been big parts of the history here. And that's what Mark does. He takes care of his players, past and present. And Gergs is he's here to help out to see if he likes it. We're recruiting right now. So this is his first day. He was here at 6:15, ready to go. But as you brought up, past faces that have been here before understand the culture, understand what we're trying to do, and so it's great to have them in the building.
Jason, DwayneFriesMath.com. Just tell us how the first day went and the first time seeing these guys in the first day of training camp.
Dwayne, today was a great day. You know, the excitement, the energy was very high. Guys, you know, played hard, competed. They did everything we asked. No injuries. As you guys got to watch there, the scrimmage was competitive. Everybody wants to win. It was a great first day. Well, as coaches now, we'll go back and look at the video and see some of the things we have to clean up. But I thought the energy and effort and the communication was at an all-time high.
And one other thing, the game last night, did you get the chance to go? What you think of the Cowboys?
Oh, the Cowboys were rocking last night. The stadium was rocking, and the Cowboys have a very good team, and they played at a very high level last night. Finley had gotten us some very nice seats there in the end zone so we could see the game. So it was really nice.
Hey, Tim Cato with The Athletic. Would you say there's a specific focus in this training camp, offense, defense, or just something else more generally?
Yeah, you know, I think, Tim, when you talk about what we're trying to accomplish here at training camp is chemistry and accountability. Those two things we talked about yesterday as a team, and we're going to talk throughout training camp and the year. And I thought today was a great start in that chemistry and also the accountability, being held accountable. Those are the things that we're going to work on, and hopefully we can get better each time we take the floor.
Callie Kaplan with the Dallas Morning News. To go off of that, Luka has said that he wants to be able to build better chemistry like he had with the Slovenian team, but how do you go about that? You know, in what ways are you, you know, trying to create that tangible chemistry and that accountability?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's going to take time to develop that chemistry. As much as we like to be in a drink form in a bottle where everybody can take it and we would have it on day one, it's going to be the journey, the experiences, good or bad, in the sense when I say bad, losses. But I think the biggest thing is you can see today the energy. You know, everybody's excited. Everybody was communicating. So chemistry is going to take time. We have a new staff and two new players that we brought on board. But I think Luka was right. You know, chemistry is something that's big. And that the Mavs have always have had in the past, and hopefully we can have it this season.
Hey, Jason, Brad Towns of Dallas Morning News. A little bit more about Tyson Chandler. Some of the guys yesterday were talking about how much they've enjoyed working with him. What specifically would you like to see him impart? What are the things you're seeing and hope to get from his presence here?
Brad, when you talk about Tyson and his presence, I think we all will start with his voice. He's a great communicator. He's been here, don't quote me, but somewhere in July, August, August maybe, we started helping out, and wanted to see if he liked it. He loves it. Sometimes we tease him that we should maybe look at a 10-day. He's in great shape. But I think what Tyson brings is just who he is. And for the people who have been around him, he's always been a giver, always willing to help. When he was a teammate of mine, he was always there to protect. And so I think that's just who he is. He's in there trying to pass on what he's learned coming out of high school, which was a long, long time ago. But I think he hasn't changed. And we're lucky to have someone like that that can help bigs. When you talk about KP, Boban, you saw him in there sparring with Boban, made him look small. But also, we have some young players. When you talk about Moses Brown, being able to help Moses, it was great to hear players mention him yesterday. And that's just a sign of Tyson's doing the right thing.
Hey, Jason, Chuck Cooperstein, Mavs Radio. Just about Gergs, obviously he was here. He was here when we won in 2011. And he's always been just a great mentor toward coaches. What do you see from him toward you as a coach versus you as a player?
Cooper, that's a great question. I think when you talk about Gergs, he's a father figure. You know, he's created a lot of jobs for NBA coaches. When you talk about development, when he first came in the league to Seattle, he helped quite a few players on that team, and other teams started to see what he was doing in the summer, and then on the court, and other franchises started adding more coaches to develop. And so he's the godfather of coaches. For a young coaching staff and a young head coach, he can help me. I can lean on him. I would say, to go out on a limb, he's seen everything. There's nothing that he hasn't seen. And so to be able to bounce different ideas off of him, and the beauty of Gertz is he's always going to be honest. And he was here when we did win. He was honest with Dirk about his defense. And Dirk told him the truth, that it's about offense. So they have a great relationship. But that's what, Gergs is to everybody here as the Mavs family. He's always going to be part of the Mavs family because he helped us win.
Okay, we're going to go with Zoom with Kevin Gray.
Kevin Gray, 105 through the Fan. Jason, good to see you. You talked about chemistry and accountability as something you've already talked about with this team. From a philosophical standpoint, what do you want to impart to this team, especially during this first week, to really establish a foundation as you guys get ready for preseason action and then into the regular season?
Well, I think the biggest thing is, as we talk about chemistry and accountability, that comes along with trust. Just trusting each other, may be on the defensive end. If someone gets beat, there's going to be a teammate there to help. And then on the offensive end, being unselfish, and again, we talked about it yesterday. We're very good at breaking down the defense and making the extra pass. And so can we be accountable to do that, on a nightly basis? And everybody agreed that we can. And so those are the type of things that we're going to work on daily to get there. And hopefully continue to talk about that in January and February when everybody's looking for the All-Star break.
Hey, Coach Ian, A2ZSports.com. You've talked a lot about defense yesterday and when you were first introduced back in the middle of the summer. What is the science into getting a team to buy into defending at a high level? And how do you plan to do that with this group of guys, with a lot of them playing together for some time?
It's a big thing for us is we want to get better on the defensive end. When you talk about steals or deflections, we were 30th. Can we get better? We all believe that we can. Sometimes it's just a little effort. And then also just talking about it on a daily basis, starting practice with a defensive drill, maybe ending practice with a defensive drill where it becomes, you know, the norm. It's just like today's game has changed from when I played. Now you see everyone's practicing threes. Now threes have become an important part of our game. So I think when we are out on the floor for practice, defense is something that all the coaches are preaching. And hopefully, you know, that will translate game time.
Okay,
one more, Leonardo.
Hi, Coach. It's Leonardo Torres from Peru. Hope you're well. Coach, from what we saw last season, which was great from Luca, in what area do you expect him to improve this season?
Well, I would take the numbers that he had last year. They were pretty good. I think maturity. I think he's 22 years old. He understands what it takes to win. I think one of the biggest things that we'll talk about internally and then, you know, for his play is trying to take some of that heavy lifting where he can trust his teammates to carry some of that load for him so he doesn't have to do everything on a nightly basis.
Josh, DwayneCrocsMouth.com. Just talk to us a little bit about your Olympic experience, some of the things that you learned when you was up there in Tokyo.
I think I was able to learn a lot. I'll say more off the court than on the court. I think having guys like Patty Mills, Joe Ingles, Dellavedova, Aaron Baines, you know, just seeing the way how they handle, themselves off the court recovery wise and just what they do as far as leadership for a team. You know, I meant a lot for the younger guys coming through the Australian system. So, you know, I think, just learning that type of thing helped me more than it did on the court. And then obviously on the court, you know, it's very competitive. You know, our goal was to ultimately get the gold medal. So, you know, every day for a month, we're scrimmaging twice a day, just getting after it.
Tim Cato at The Athletic. Are the yellow crocs still in steady rotation?
They're actually framed right now. I'm joking. No. They are actually, yeah.
Nice. Is there a single thing you want to improve on this year? What do you look at this season and what does it represent to you and what you want to accomplish as a player?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's just a new opportunity. You know, we have a great staff here, new staff, new opportunity for everybody. You know, me, my biggest thing is coming in with confidence, knowing what I can do to help the team. And yeah, just coming in, just giving it my all, and I'm ready to go.
Okay, we have a question on Zoom. Kevin Gray.
Kevin Gray, 105 through the Fan. Josh, for you, can you kind of talk about your mindset at the end of the season and now having a summer to really work on your game and coming into this year, what this opportunity means and what kind of mindset that you have coming into the season with a new coaching staff?
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the season, I mean, I think it was cool being out to, you know, get minutes as, you know, steady minutes in the rotation towards the end and, you know, kind of getting momentum from that, but also learning on what I need to improve on to be better next season. So, you know, I think that helped me and I was able to take that to Las Vegas, work out with my trainer and, you know, other guys and Kyle Lowry and stuff like that. So it's been amazing. You know, I feel like I've been able to learn so much as a player.
Yeah, Josh, how much you feel you lost last year by not having a summer league and a full training camp?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say it was the same as a normal year, but, you know, I wouldn't use it as an excuse. You know, I think it's one of those things where it's just the given year. I mean, everybody's year is kind of messed up. So, you know, for me, you know, I can look at it like that, but at the same time, you know, just build off it. Look at it as more of a head start to this year.
Callie Kaplan with the Dallas Morning News. A couple of quick questions. First, where do you keep your medal and have you talked to Luca about that game very much?
My medal is, I just moved apartments. My medal is just next to my bed. but no, I have not talked to him about that and I'll try not to, you know.
It's probably a smart approach.
Yeah.
And second, I know it's not a huge sample size from last year, but what differences have you noticed in the way that practice is conducted or the way that seemed like at least at the end that we got to see energy was pretty high? What have you noticed the differences being in the way that this new staff operates?
Yeah, I mean, I think just overall, it's such a competitive environment. You know, today at practice, you know, it was one of the most fun practices we've been a part of, you know, just because of the way we, you know, approached it. Everybody was together moving the ball. And, you know, it's always fun to be a part of that and going at each other and just, you know, just doing what we love to do. And that's play basketball. So, overall, you know, I think that it's a great vibe, you know, whether it's off the court, on the court, just yesterday, media day, you know, everybody was having fun seeing each other. So, you know, I think it's one of those things, but, you know, we're ready to go.
Josh, Chuck Cooperstein, Mavs Radio. Obviously, you didn't get to play a lot in the Olympics, but you're around tremendous players and tremendous coaching and in trying to develop your game. How much do you think just being in that atmosphere, even though you weren't playing very much, helped you along to where you are right now?
Yeah. I mean, even though I wasn't playing that much, I would say I was able to get in the gym a lot. I was able to lift as much as I wanted to. There was open gyms at the Olympic Village every single day. So I was putting in a lot of work. I was putting in more work, if not more work than I would usually do. You know, having conversations with older guys like Patty Mills, Joe Ingles. You know, so I was able to learn so much and so much more than that. You know, we had a core group of younger guys throughout the camp and in the camp where we were able to scrimmage. You know, I was defending Patty, I was defending Joe every single day. You know, younger guys like Matisse, just picking their brains and just really learning. So overall, you know, yeah, you can look at it like at that point, but I was putting in more than enough work to make sure I'm ready to go. So.
Josh. All right. Thank you, Josh.
Thank you. Appreciate it.